A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 3rd Feb, on the front page you have second case of coronavirus infection confirmed in Kerala. So India's second case of novel coronavirus has been confirmed in Alappuzha in Kerala after a student admitted to the isolation ward of the government medical college tested positive. So another student here has been tested positive of novel coronavirus. So they had returned recently from Wuhan. So we had seen first case and now this is the second one. And this is money earned in India by NRIs will be taxed. So Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has tried to allay fears that provisions introduced in the budget which are bringing NRIs under taxation. So this is, she's clarifying that this is for taxing the income in the country, because what the budget said is Indian workers means NRIs income in zero tax jurisdictions, means countries in which they are not paying taxes like UAE, so they will come under Indian tax net, means whatever they earn. But now clarification has been given that this is on what they earn in India. So letter came from Kerala CM to Kerala, from Kerala many people go to Dubai, so it will have impact on workers in West Asia especially. So what the budget has actually done, it has changed the definition of NRIs. So you should know first of all that the budget, when it is passed, it is in the form of two bills. So now these two bills have been introduced. These are appropriation bill and finance bill. So the finance bill has included these changes. So it proposes three major changes to prevent tax abuse by citizens who don't pay taxes anywhere in the world. So it has reduced the number of days that an Indian citizen can be granted non-resident status for tax purposes. So a person who is considered as an NRI for taxation purpose, it was 182 days, that is 6 months. So this has been reduced to 120 days. So means for 120 days, if you are not paying taxes, you know, anywhere in the world, so then the person is granted non-resident status. Citizens who don't pay taxes anywhere will be deemed to be a resident, is what the second change says. And definition of not ordinarily resident has been tightened. So here you can see, so non-resident status as such is for 120 days, reduced to 120 days, means these Indian citizens can stay in the country for a stretch for 120 days. Means out of 120, you can see if it was 182 earlier, this was approximately 6 months. So for 6 months abroad, 6 months they can be in India. But now they are not for the definition for NRI is not to be 6 months abroad, but for 245 days abroad. So you can see, so that is 4 months here and 8 months abroad. So that's how the definition has changed now. So that is that. Then below you have Nirbhaya case, center seeks not for executions. So we had seen the court gave more time for the convicts to exhaust their appeals and curative petition, so and even mercy petitions. So the hanging of all accused will be delayed, because even if one person's petitions are pending, so the case will not seek hanging of other convicts, co-convicts as such. That is the rule. So now center has moved Supreme Court and says that your credibility, the judiciary's credibility is at stake, and hanging should be conducted as soon as possible. And here you have unidentified miscreants open fire at Jamia Millia Islamia. So two unidentified bike-borne men. So every day we are hearing this case of firing opened on peaceful anti-citizenship amendment act protests. So this firing also was in the air. So it is clear that they fired two rounds in the air and sped away. So it is clear the objective of this is to scare the protesters. Then below you have study on bat hunters of Nagaland under scanner. So this is about bat hunters. So they have these antibodies as such, which can work against deadly virus like Ebola. So research has been carried out by researchers from US, China and India on this. So it can fight against SARS and other such diseases. which and most of these diseases are those in which bat is a carrier. So these bat hunters have these antibodies. On page 4 you have Haryana's Harappan site to create jobs. So this is in Rakhigarh. The budget announced that a national museum would be set up here. So this would bring in jobs as such too, and the villagers here have welcomed it. On page 5 you have farmers threaten stir if procurement policy is changed. So this is regarding the open-ended procurement policy, which is how the government functions presently. The minimum support price is announced by the government and it procures food grains from farmers. But recently, like Commission for Agricultural Costs and Prices has recommended to the center that this policy should change because there is a mounting food stock. So because of this, recommendations being given has resulted in farmers protesting. They say changes in open-ended procurement policy is the first step. Eventually, they will put an end to the minimum support price purchase too. As we saw, the economic survey also speaks of government intervention to be minimized, to be reduced. It wants the wealth creators to create the wealth, and like through a trickle-down effect, you can say, the country would benefit. So government has to not make interventions here, social interventions. It said we are a capitalist country. Socialism was an aberration, was a mistake which we did, deviated from the path for some years. And since liberalization, we have seen economy progressing. So we don't need to be socialist. So here also fears have been raised amongst farmers that eventually government would opt out of these policies too. So they are protesting. On page 7, you have new mascot for national games. So Goa state bird, the flame-throated bulbul, as such has been revealed as the official mascot of 36th national games, which will be held in Goa. So this bird, flame-throated bulbul, it's called Rubigula. So that is the mascot. So national games, 36th national games will be held between October 20 and November 4, 2020. And 36 states and union territories are expected to participate in these games in 37 disciplines. It will be held across 24 venues in Goa. On page 8, you have rituals vital to Sabarimala temple's essential practices. So this is what has been stated before the Supreme Court. It is said non-secular courts can't be put to the test of Article 14. So we have seen 9-judge constitutional bench looking at larger issue. So all religious faiths are putting forth their viewpoints before the court. So this is Sabarimala practices, Sabarimala temple case. So on this also, submission has come before the 9-judge bench. And this is 2130 Kerala islands now under CRZ cover. So in coastal regulation zone regime has been extended to 2130 backwater islands of Kerala, which includes Maradu. So there will be curbs on development activities in these regions. So you can see in these islands, in an area between high tide line and 50 meters towards the landward side, no new development activity will be permitted. So that is the CRZ area of these islands. What is high tide line is also explained. You can see it's the line on the land up to which the highest water line reaches during the spring tide. So when water is coming closest, which is the line till which it reaches. So that is called high tide line. From high tide line till 50 meters towards the landward side, no development activity is allowed. On page 9, you have doctors turn activists against paraquat poisoning. So this is regarding use of herbicide in agricultural fields. So because of this, people are affected and many have to visit hospitals. So now doctors have picked up this case. So many deaths have taken place. You can see 157 deaths, mostly of farmers, have taken place since September 2017. And this is because of paraquat, which is a herbicide used in agricultural fields. So young doctors have become now activists speaking against this. On editorial page, the first editorial is cognizant of constraints. So the 15th Finance Commission gave its recommendations, but it tried not to rock the devolution boat since GST's ongoing troubles, because of GST's ongoing troubles. So the interim report again has come of 15th Finance Commission. It was tabled in Parliament on Saturday, and it has largely preserved the devolution mathematics of its predecessor. So state share, as such, you can see, is coming to 41%. So it has recommended a 1 percentage point reduction. That is it. Presently, it is 42%. Also, other recommendations which it has given is like, notional share of Jammu and Kashmir based on parameters for horizontal devolution. It comes to about 0.85%. But Commission says there are security and other special needs of the two newly created union territories. So the aggregate share will be 1%, which should be met by the center. So within that, within state share, each state share is also recommended. So that is there. The next editorial is no room for panic. So this is regarding the novel coronavirus. So it says the best way to stop the spread of the virus is to raise public awareness and not panic. The lead article is falling short of aspirations. So this is regarding economic outlook as such. And the government has targets and made promises. So government has to meet these targets, especially the investment targets which it has proposed. So it talks on the budget and various schemes, how they have been, like on flagship welfare schemes, how the allocation has been reduced. That is covered. And private investment also been proposed. So where all these investments should actually turn into reality, should not be just promises and statements in the budget. Then this is the budget's blurred social sector vision. So this talks of low allocation and specific policy statements which point to greater privatization and withdrawal of the state. So as we said, government says we are not socialists, we are capitalists. So that is a huge concern. Then on op-ed page, you have, it's time for Shaheen Bagh protests to end. So protesters are becoming pawns in the electoral game is what this article says. And the Shaheen Bagh protests have to end. The government said they will start talks with them. But how far will they go and what will be the result? We have to see. On page 12, you have Center rejects advice on special grants for states. So the 15th Finance Commission made its recommendation. It's recommended 6,776 crore should be given to states as grants to ensure that they do not receive less than the perceived year's location, than the previous year's location. So this recommendation has not been accepted by the center. So that is it. So this is also an interim report presently. On page 13, you have removal of DDT, that is dividend distribution tax, which the budget has proposed. This article says will boost investments. This is a statement given by Central Board of Direct Taxes. So, Center believes that the new regime will encourage low-income people to invest in the capital market. On international page, you have, this is regarding first coronavirus death outside China. So, this has been reported in Philippines. A 44-year-old man from Wuhan developed severe pneumonia and died. Then this is UK to seek Canada-style free trade deal with European Union. So UK has exited from EU, but it wants a trade agreement and it is seeking a Canada-like agreement. So it says it is said such a pact is viable only if Britain brings its rules in line with EU regulations. So that is the statement being given by EU. Then on Mondays on business page, you have this money wise coverage, which is on individual investments and how to deal with money. So this can be skipped. So these were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asr.com. Thank you.